This clip will show you additional style settings available for the revision history object. The revision history settings panel of the object settings dialog contains many settings for this object. At the top of the panel, the long selection button lets you select the various tab pages of the panel. The first tab page contains style-related settings for the object. Some of these settings were covered in the previous feature clip. The four checkboxes in the middle right of the tab page let you set additional geometry options for the object. If you check the frame checkbox, a frame will be generated for the revision history table. If you check the horizontal separators checkbox, horizontal lines will be generated between table rows, while checking the vertical separators checkbox will generate vertical lines between table columns. Checking the Show First Revision checkbox will display the first revision, which is part of the first issue for all layouts. Unchecking this checkbox lets you skip this row of the table. The bottom area of the tab page lets you set text-related settings. The first line contains settings related to regular table rows. The first two fields let you set the font type and font size respectively, while these four additional buttons let you set these rows to bold, italic, underline, and strike-through font styles. The title checkbox lets you display a title row for the table by checking the checkbox. There is also a field next to this checkbox where you can specify where the title row should be located. Its default setting is top, but you can also display it at the bottom of the table. Lastly, there's another row of settings below these two fields that let you set the font type, font size, and font style options for the title row.